Hey guys, Switchup here with another live game commentary today. We've got time for our special lined up for ya. It is this weird ass new meta Korean Shyvana build. Don't really know what's going on with this one, but I saw it and it looks really interesting. I've been playing a few games of it, fine tuning things a little bit and getting a better understanding of it so I can teach you guys how this weird ass build does indeed work. So Shyvana with Ginzus. Yes, that's what we're going to be doing today, boys and girls. Bit strange, but Shyvana is actually the third highest win rate jungler in Korea right now. So, something must be right with this ship. Not everyone does this build, but it's something that's been popping up and it's really interesting. So, we're going to give it a pop today and just talk a little bit about it as well. So, first things first, your runes and masteries though, guys. You want to go for your AD reds, your attack speed quints, your armor yellows, and magic resist blues. And for masteries, 18-12-0 with fervor. Fervor for battle is actually the mastery of choice on Shyvana. This whole Ginzu's build is very, very heavily focused towards on hit damage. Now Shyvana is no, what's the word I'm looking for? No, What's this word? No stranger. That's the word. Holy shit. Mind went blank. No stranger to on-hit damage is Shyvana. In fact, pretty much the core of Shyvana's damage comes from the fact that she does have this huge on-hit element to her kit. And attack speed is a great stat on her for similar reasons. She gets loads of benefits from attack speed. And one of them, of course, is the fact that she just does a crap ton of damage when she has attack speed because of loads of on-hit damage. So, loads of on-hit damage with this build. Really, really strong 1v1s in that sense. Shyvana already has really strong 1v1s, so even stronger 1v1s. It's really interesting, build. And of course, fervor helps you set up those 1v1s even better and really gets that kind of on-hit damage going even further. Because fervor, when you press Q, you get a shit ton of stacks on it. So really, really nice mastery to be picking up on her. Now, Shyvana as a champion, you guys may not know this, but in Season 2, Shyvana was my best champion. I was a fanboy of Diamond Prox from Moscow 5, and he brought Shyvana into the meta and was counter-jungled all the time with her, and it was really, really fun to watch. And ever since then, I just picked her up and got really good in her. It was Shyvana jungle that got me to, like, you know, Master Tier equivalent in Season 2 and in Season 3. Even last year, I had a 90% win rate on her. And then I lost the game and I never picked her up again. But, you know, so I know how Shyvana works at least. So hopefully I can teach you guys how she functions. Anyway, this guy is by himself here and Nautilus isn't walking up just yet. So I should be okay here to bully this guy. Although I've got to be a little bit careful here. Nice, there's his flash. Alright, so I'm going to get collapsed here and I'm probably going to die. There's Katarina. Unfortunately, I didn't quite have the awareness on the minimap that I should have done. It was pretty good in itself, but I got a bit greedy there and I didn't realize Katarina was coming up, which is my bad. I've been awake for too long. My brain wasn't focused on the minimap. Always, if you're ever going to invade, guys, always have your escape route planned before you invade. Because stuff like that can happen, and that's really bad. We don't want to die like that. Alright, okay. Let's focus a bit more now, right? I'm talking too much shit about fucking Shyvana and all that bullshit. Let's get into the game, okay? So, Shyvana as a champion is a strong bully champion, very strong in 1v1s, but her ganking is not that great because she doesn't have any kind of CC for herself. Her burst damage at this level is not amazing either, and the fact that she doesn't have really any gap closer. She can run pretty fast, but that's about it. So if you're going to go for ganks, which is possible on Shyvana, you have to make sure that you either have a lot of setup for your ganks, or that you just find someone in a really, really bad position. So I'm not going to be looking to gank this game. Like, I'm not going to be trying to force things, but I will be looking to see, you know, like, invading the enemy jungler is good, you know, as long as you don't suicide while doing it. I will mostly just be looking to punish people that are overextended, but outside of that, just farming. Because I always feel like on Shyvana, in this very early game, you're actually not that strong. You're not, I wouldn't say you're weak. I mean, you saw me bully Graves, right? So I can't be that weak, right? But you're not, you're a lot stronger in, like, the mid game. Shyvana's win rate around the 30-minute mark, like if games end like at 30 minutes, her win rate is like almost, it's number two. Like she's almost not like the best jungler like for the around the 30-minute mark. She's because she just reaches that point where she has crazy amounts of damage, but no one really has enough damage to kill her yet. So it's that sweet spot where her damage is still really relevant and everyone else's damage is not quite so relevant. So if you can get to that point where you are, you know, at the 30-minute mark-ish, that kind of thing. If you can get to that point, it's beautiful on Shyvana. But the early game is not as good, really, on her. It's not terrible. Like you saw, it's not terrible. But it's not really something that you should be forcing, and farming up is fine. My kind of general rule of thumb for it with Shyvana is that farming until you get your first big jungle item is okay. You know, that's kind of something you can aim for, and that's fine. So for this build, it will be the Bloodraiser. You can go Cinderhulk on Shyvana if you want to, but honestly, I would just recommend going Bloodraiser. And for this build, we will be doing Bloodraiser as well. So yeah, it's really solid. Once you get Bloodraiser, you should be sorted, and then you can just proper hard bully people. Now, one downside to this build, however, is that you are extremely squishy for a pretty long time. Normally, Shyvana gets a little bit tanky. Wait, is no one going to help me with this? What the fuck? We just recalled bot lane? God damn it. I might be able to solo this still, I don't know. Normally on Shyvana you get a tad tanky. Yeah, they know I'm doing it as well. Because Morgana's coming up here. Well, at least she flashed as well there. That's a bit of a tilt right there. There's no reason for you guys to leave me alone like that. We could have taken that for free. Graves was top. Anyway, normally on Shyvana, Devour is fine. You can just farm up to get that and it's fine. It would have been really nice to actually get that dragon there because it's a fire dragon, which is a really important one to have. But we just wanted to recoil instead, so these guys can't take that though without being punished, so that's fine. In fact, if I can get a honey, is there a honey fruit in this river? There's one in the bot river I saw. Oh shit, they got that already. Fuck. I guess I can't honey fruit that. If I could honey fruit, I could have invaded his topside jungle. I don't know. I'm pretty sure his red buff's up at least. I'm just really nervous of this Katarina. This Katarina is just like, she's got her eyes glued on the minimap this game. She's always roaming for me. It's really annoying. I wish I was against the lazy mid laner. That would be so nice. Just give me the lazy mid laner so I can just chill out. But anyway, we'll just keep farming here. There's a ward there, so I just walk right past. Would be a bit risky to go and dive bot here because we don't know where Graves is. In fact, he's probably going to be around bot side, most likely. So you got to respect that because Graves, of course, is not someone you want to run into when you're going for a dive. Now, as far as your second jungle item goes here, like your tier 2 jungle item, I should say. So like Stalker's Blade, Skirmisher's Saber. Which one you go for is kind of up to you. Stalker's Blade is really nice for ganks. And it, you know, sometimes I find myself having this Skirmisher Saber and being like, God, I wish I had Blue Smite here. If you're new to Shyvana, you can just go for Blue Smite and, you know, you can't really go wrong with it. I don't want to make it sound like Blue Smite is a bad option on her because it really isn't. For me, though, Red Smite is really nice because it just gives you that extra oomph, especially if you find yourself in, like, kind of dodgy jungle matchups, like the one I'm in now against Graves, because Graves is a champion. Pretty hard to play against. He's probably the strongest jungler, actually, honestly, overall. So if you're playing versus Graves, you can expect a bit of a pounding. And Red Smite takes the edge off a little bit. Anyway, let's see if we can do something here. We might be able to get in on this one. I'm not sure, but we might be able to. Well, it looks like we're just going to hard shove all the time. So might not work. This bush could be warded as well. I don't really want to force this, but we might be able to do something. They're a little bit low, and the tower is pretty low as well. We can just force the tower, actually, can't we? Beautiful. Oh, we're going in, apparently. All right, that's fine. Get the flash. We should definitely try and go for this dragon at some point, I feel like. But I don't, like, this is another thing which I don't think we can force too much, because against the Katarina, going for, like, small enclosed spaces, fighting in small enclosed spaces is actually extremely risky because she just turns on you. But she's actually gone for an early Negatron as well, which really isn't what I want to see personally. Oh shit, I did not want to be here though. Early Negatron is actually quite scary because for me, I actually do a lot of magic damage, so can't even get in on this one, can I? Oh my goodness. Let's just try and get mid here. I don't think we can really stop this stuff from happening bot lane, so we'll just try and get mid instead. Everyone's gone bot at least, so, you know, that's a, it's a possibility, but... I don't know, man. I feel like we're just being so lazy. Like, there's so many times I feel like Annie probably should have roamed here. I don't know. At least they're coming to defend this rather than just doing dragon, though. That would kind of suck if they just went for dragon there. See if I can get these. Oh, they're not up. That's fine. Wait for this. Spot this out. I may have to end up just like giving up this dragon, though. Like, dragon is a really hard objective to contest if you don't have a strong jungler or a strong mid laner. And I don't think we have either of those two here. I think that both our mid and jungler are weaker than theirs, so I think that's a bit hard for me to go for. So I'm just going to give it up. I don't like giving up a fire dragon, that is for sure. Oh fuck, but we might be able to get something. Like, I feel like this is the lesser of two evils, so to speak. And we get a kill, so that's cool as well. As someone who plays Nautilus, by the way, I have no idea how you beat a Fiora. I should add this guy after the game and ask him how he does it. Because Fiora is one of these champions who if I ever see her in my game and I'm playing Shyvana, I'm playing Nautilus, I just physically cannot beat her. Like, I just don't, there's just like no avenue to beat a Fiora as Nautilus. It just doesn't happen. Look at this bitch, man. She is constantly on my penis. It's really irritating. What the fuck? Alright, well at least that's her flash down, I guess. There it is. Alright, fair enough. She should die here, actually. I don't think she'll survive. Oh, I don't know if I'm going to execute. She'll probably execute, right? Yeah. Damn. I don't even think I hit her there, to be fair. Well, I eat her in the river, but when she dove at me, I don't think I got her. Anyway, we got our Blood Razor here. Now, this is a pretty big power spike for Shyvana. Blood Razor gives you like a lot of damage. So right now I can power farm through the jungle really easily. I should be able to farm really easily. My 1v1 should be better. I know this, like, it's not going well for us at all right now. That Nautilus was actually our first kill at Nautilus kill top. It's not going well for us, but this isn't where I'm like at my strongest anyway, so that is a positive. And also on top of that, I've done a lot of stuff on the map, which is nice. I could have also had a dragon, but I think it was a good time to go for dragon, but we, you know, whatever. Basically, it's fine. We're not going for the kills here. The game isn't over yet, though, and if I just farm up, we'll be fine. Good job, Annie. I'm going to spread some positivity in this chat here, because there's not a lot of it, honestly. I know I've whined a little bit about Annie just, like, being glued to her lane, but notice how I'm only whining to you guys, because whining in chat does like achieves nothing, so don't do that. Not good. Don't whine in chat. There's no purpose to it. I probably shouldn't even be whining to you guys. It's just whining. It's not fun to listen to, but you know, just talking about the game really. But I'm just gonna like keep farming here, because I've got such, like, look how fast I just powered through this jungle now that I've got my Blood Razor. It's so fast. Little notes to make, by the way, about your mechanics when you're clearing on Shyvana, in general on Shyvana. You want to tag things with your E and then use your Q as an auto attack reset and move in between each of your autos, so you can like especially if you're chasing someone, so you can keep up with them. Max and Q after your Q after W. But yeah, it's pretty, like, the reason why you want to use your Q is auto attack reset. It makes a big difference, especially like, are we not able to just like, okay, I actually missed my E there. That's fine. Could we not have collapsed on him a little bit faster there? I feel like he was standing up here for a good, like, 5 to 10 seconds. I think we could have done something there, but that's okay. All's well that ends well. And Siv is doing a work in this bot lane. So what I'm going to do here is we're going to pressure this mid. Okay, that's bad. That's a stun. Just going to chill out here, because I don't want to get too deep on that one, because Graves is a bit of a problem. And then we'll go for the safer play here. There we go, get his flash. Oh shit, I could be in a pickle here though. Safer play, he dies. That was close though, that was close. I almost didn't get caught by that. Yeah, That was a bit unfortunate, though, yeah. And his ult did just come up. I thought maybe we could get on the djinn and blow him up. But that's okay. That's fine. Maybe I should just abandon Sona and just let her leave her to die. But you don't want to leave your teammates like that, do you? It was bad. Anyway, so we're going to go in towards the Ginzus here. The way the Ginzus works, like I say, it's very heavily... Nice, good job, Annie. It's very heavy on the on-hit side of things. And it also has like an activation effect. Not an active effect. You don't use it. You don't use the item like you use Zhonya's. I mean activation in the sense that once you kind of... almost like an unlocked effect, I guess. Once you unlock it, you get a like crap ton of extra damage with it, basically. Holy shit. I am so slow. Tier 1 boots. Getting kited by someone with red buff. That's not fun. So yeah, basically, what Ginzu's does is whenever you hit people, you gain stacks. And once you reach 6 stacks, you get a shit ton of damage. If you guys remember the old Sated Devourer, which gave you that Phantom Strike. It's that, basically. So again, really heavy on the on-hit side of things, which is really nice. And it means that in your 1v1s, you do a crap ton of damage. The only downside is that you have to obviously find the 1v1s, and it's easy to run away from a Shyvana. Well, it can be easy to run away from a Shyvana, depending on the situation in which you find her. But I'm just going to keep farming here. Like that's another Fire Dragon. We can't lose that one, though. I'm going to keep farming here, just getting some gold. All that lovely shit. Oh, we want to go for Herald. Okay. I don't think we can lose that, honestly. If we lose 2 Fire Dragons, is that not a really big deal? I think it's more important, though, to make sure that we secure this for Fiora. I don't have my ward up, though. Katarina did walk towards here, so I'm a little bit nervous, but I don't think she knows we're on this. That's nice. We'll give that to Fiora. That gives her stronger 1v1s, split pushing. We can, we dedicated to the Herald there, so we're going to lose Dragon, which I'm not really a fan of doing, but I think that it could be worse, I guess. Yeah, I don't really think that's worth it, honestly, but we'll see. Like, if Fiora starts popping off, it would be worth it, so we'll see. Anyway, do I want to stay mid here? Oh shit, there's Nautilus. Hello. Nautilus is actually really squishy. I mean, he's got Rod of Ages for health, but he's not tanky, really. So, he should be quite easy for me to kill. We might be able to get this tower, though. I don't want to... What the fuck? I don't want to dedicate, too hard. Why am I still tanking this tower? Anyone know that? That's right, you don't have to tank for me, boys. Goodbye, Annie. I thought I dropped that tower like twice there. Apparently not. Holy shit, this Katarina is big. Oh my god. Mate, that is not cool, man. We didn't even get the tower. Alright, we're nearly in on our Ginzus, though. Once we get that, we're unlocking the next part, boys. Hopefully we don't lose the game before then. We're not having a good start, are we? Katarina's popping off really hard. And I'm 1-4-1, holy shit. RIP. 0-5 bot lane as well. So really the only thing that's going well for us this game is the Fiora. And Annie every now and then does good stuff, so maybe we can play around those. I should get to, I should be able to do good shit, though. So I'm going to go buy my Ginzus here. We'll get chickens first, if they're even up. And then I'm going to start, split pushing, I think, and trying to find the enemy jungler. Because I feel like that's where I'm, not the enemy jungler necessarily, just enemy players. I don't want to group anymore, because, I don't think the grouping is what this build is good at, so... I just want to split push and find people. I don't know. It's a bit tricky though, honestly, because this Katarina is really strong, so I probably can't fight her. And Graze, to an extent as well, is probably someone I can't fight. Depending on the situation, he's pretty squishy, so I might be able to. But he's also fairly strong as far as damage goes, so... Not really someone that I want to run into. Yeah, you be careful there, Sona. Alright, she should be dead here. I'll let Fiora get that one. You can see that damage though is pretty big. I wasn't on her for very long there and she died pretty fast still, so that's nice. She also has an abyssal, so she takes a lot less damage from me than a lot of these other people will be doing. So that's nice. And like I say, Nautilus is not tanky. He's not building any MR. He's got health, but that's it. Downside to this build, which honestly is something which I don't like about this build, is the fact that I'm so bloody squishy. I really, you know, getting frozen mallet is something that Koreans do a lot in this on Shyvana. And I kind of like that, but I think Titanic Hydra is also really good. So like Titanic Hydro, Frozen Mallet, whatever. Those are really nice items to get on Shyvana, and usually you would see those second rather than third, which is what we'll be doing in this build. You go Ginzu's into Frozen Mallet, but it's all good. Now they've actually got three people in bot lane, so I don't know if I can, but I might be able to pressure something top. Now I don't want to show top because I have no wards, so I could easily get collapsed on here. But Ginzu Shyvana. Yeah, he's going. You know what? So can I just like fucking mute everyone in this game? Wait, why did that not work? Okay, there we go. So I want to see if I can find this Nautilus. I really want to see how much damage I do to him. I don't know. He's okay. There he is. He's here. He was just clearing out the Krug camp. But I don't want to run into Katarina, and I don't know where she is. So I'm gonna pussy out of this one for a little bit, and then we'll see what happens, right? If he walks up here, we'll see what happens. He's only got tier 1 boots as well, so. Where's he going? He's actually buggering off. He's legit out of it. Alright, mate. Goodbye. Let's keep pushing then. Like, the more I split push like this, the more I am likely to run into someone in a 1v1. Which is what I want with this build. This is not a team fighting build, especially this stage of the game when I'm really squishy. So, I do want to try and just, like, pressure a lane and see if I can draw people towards me. But I am the same level as this Katarina, and I'm almost a high level than her. So that's pretty good at least by itself. Yeah, I'm not going to sit on a lane there too much and tempt fate, because that would be pretty bad. I don't want to jump in on that. See if there's split pushing bot, which actually by itself is not that bad. But it is bad if we're all here top and she's bot, so if she wants to go bot, that's fine, but we have to respect the fact that she is bot and not force anything. Look at this damage. Holy shit. Wow. Goodbye. The one on four Shyvana strikes again. Oh god. Nice. Okay. Good shit. Let's go for the chickens here. I don't know if I mentioned this yet, though. I think I did mention this, but Shyvana's win rates skyrocket at the 30-minute mark. So if this game, like around the 30 minutes, around 30 minutes is when Shyvana is like at her strongest. Just yo, I don't need to outrun Nautilus or Graves. I just need to outrun the Sona. Keep swimming, Foxy. That's all good though. They're going for the dragon here. I don't know why Sivir is inting though. Why is she inting? We even got first blood tower. That was pretty good. But okay, whatever. I mean, she's still applying a decent amount of pressure. As weird as it sounds to try and draw a silver lining out of this one, yeah, she's not that useless. I don't like the fact that they've got three dragons so far though. I'm not happy about that one. I want to be careful. I want to get this, but I don't want to die to Graves here. So I'm going to stand really far back and just beat the shit. Look at that. Disgusting. Vile. Disgusting. All right. Let's keep going here, boys. Baron of it. Like, we've lost a lot of dragons. And in itself, that's not great. But it wouldn't be as big as losing a Baron. So I want to make sure I'm still in, like, a position to If something's happening around Baron, I want to be around. I'm also going to go for tier 2 boots here. Important to get these boots so that you can chase people down without getting kited too much. But I am going to stick with the warding totem here. Warding totem, I think, is more useful if I'm split pushing. It's also more useful if you're kind of behind as a team, which I don't really feel like we're... Well, I would argue we are behind this game as a team. And the warding totem allows you to like ward out your own kind of like your own jungle and stuff, which is nice. Like sweeper is good to set up plays and stuff, denying vision from the enemy team, but it's not particularly useful. Why can't I hear Azonias? Am I crazy or could I hear Azonias there? That was weird. Is it on cat? Yeah, it's on cat, right? I can hear permanent Azonias. That's annoying. Yeah, when you're setting up play sweep is good to deny vision, but when you are behind, you kind of just need vision of your own. You don't really want to like deny vision because you're not really making plays. But anyway, I'm level 15 this game, guys, which is a higher level than everyone on my team. And the only person who's the same level as me is this Graves, so I'm doing pretty well from that perspective, which is good. But we do need to be careful. Annie's coming around to flank here. I don't really think she should flank. We should just not fight here, in my opinion. We can try and set something up. Like, has she got flash? She doesn't have flash, so again, that's not an ideal situation for us. Okay, she's going in on that one though. How the hell did I get that kill? Did my W just like tickle Morgana's nutsack? Well, I don't think Morgana has a nutsack. It just tickled her and it brought her down. I'll take that. It's probably not one for boosting the old damage done statistics, but it boosts our KDA, and when you're 3 and 4, you'll take anything that you can get. Alright, should I go back to split pushing here or something? No! Don't exhaust me, dude. Come on, that's not cool. Okay, that's pretty sexy. I think I can 1v1 people now, guys. I may have even been able to kill her there, I don't know. I thought I would take a bit more damage than I did, not gonna lie. So, I was a little bit afraid of that one. Holy shit, how many blue wards these guys have? Okay, I need to recall though. I don't really want to die here. They know I'm here, which sucks, because then they could try on something on the Baron. They won't, because Jhin is dead, but they could, I guess, in theory. Nice. Whew. All right, boys. The mid-game queen. Not sure that's how riposte works, mate. I think you might have to put it in the right direction first. Look at this split push, Sivir just getting it done. Now, I'm really confident now. Whenever I make some big plays, I start getting really confident, which means I'm probably going to get really cocky as well and probably start throwing. So hopefully, this is our way back into the game and not my ticket to starting to throw. I swear whenever I mute all, by the way, I'd get some kind of like passive stats. I just start playing so much better when I've muted everyone. I don't think these guys do Dragon Baron particularly fast, so I think I'm okay to show bot side. Whoa, whoa. Okay, good. It's fine for me to be here, honestly. It's really not a big deal. Like, the thing is, if I go bot side here and they go for Baron, we can still stop them. Like, we're strong enough to be able to stop them in that situation. And I push really fast here. This Ginzu's really, really quick split pushing here. And this tower is actually pretty low. If I see two people still in mid lane, three people dead, I know this is my calling here, guys. All they got to do is stop the ports, boys. Stop the ports, and we Gucci. There we go. I'm going to get this inhib here then, most likely. Jhin is here. Holy fuck. Yo, I am so strong. I'm so strong. Oh, shit, shit, shit. Yo, that's slow. She's got Rylies? Yo, since when does Cat build Rylies, man? Help me! Stun her. No, I'm good. I'm good. Nice, we Gucci. Oh, that's a fire dragon, man. We want to get that one. I can probably solo this as well. It's up in 10 seconds. I need something to heal up a little bit before I try and solo this. There's no honey fruit, though. Do you reckon they'll come for this, guys? Yeah, they're coming for this. Fuck. God damn it. I don't want to lose a third fire dragon, but I think I have to. That's really bad. Three fires is really hard to play against, I'll tell you that much. Although there was no graze. I could have tried to go for a steal, but no flash, no ulti. Not the easiest scenario to forge a steal in. And outside of that, if I die here, we will lose Baron. So not really worth it, honestly, either way. So I'm looking at the enemy team. I want to buy some armor here. I'm probably just going to... I'll go for the Randuin's. I think the Dead Man's Plate or Randuin's, both of them would be a decent choice here. I want to go for health and armor because it makes me like tanky, obviously. But, you know, it's still good versus like towers and stuff like that. The Randuin's as well with the AoE slow is very useful. But we'll see what goes on here. Annie's the one who's got the trigger really on this fight. If Annie ult, there it is. Yeah, I was going to say, the Annie ult really is what's going to make or break this fight. Holy shit. Three people on me, I'll take that distraction. I'll take that. I went pretty deep there though. What was all that? Oh, wow, grazed 1500 damage to me, just autos. Yeah, so I guess I do need some armor. That's fine. I went a bit deep there, didn't I, guys? A little bit too deep. That's all right though. Honestly, like, it may sound kind of lame, but it stops Jhin ulting. It draws three people onto my face there, including the Nautilus ult. I don't know if I don't know if Gray's like ulting me or something, but we basically just soaked up everything there. And you know, in team fights, you could argue that's fine as far as like my job goes, so it's really not a big deal to die like that. So that's okay. Could I have achieved similar things without dying? That's always a good question to ask. I think in that team fight, you could argue. I think you could actually argue yes, I probably could have achieved similar things without dying. Because I'm pretty sure that that Katarina pretty much is suicided anyway, right? So, it's not like I was really distracting the enemy team much. But maybe not, honestly. The Jhin ult, the Nautilus ult, I don't know. Either way, could be worse. So I'm level 17 here, pretty high level in the game. This Graves is keeping up with me really nicely. But, you know, I think I'm doing fairly well as well. I still think I shit on... Well, do I shit on Graves? I'm pretty sure I shit on Graves, honestly. But we are reaching the point now where I am at my strongest, right? And I was talking about this as well. You know, the 30-minute mark is where you're strong. So, like, it's to be expected, really, that I'm doing a lot of work here at this point in the game. But I also need to be careful that I don't just, like, fall off really hard. Can we get Graves here? If we kill Graves, this would be, like, a really free Baron for us here. Nice. That's Baron then. Good ship. He also flashed that one there. So that's really good as well. If Katarina comes in here though, I am in a bit of a pickle. So we'll pray that Katarina doesn't come in. But look how fast we do Baron here. Holy moly. Wow. Goodbye. Goodbye, Baron. And look at the healing I got from that. Crazy ship. Nice. Beautiful. Beautiful. Alright, we should be able to turn this into some really good shit here. So mid lane as well is pushing really hard, so that's going to be something. Top lane is a potential as well. I think we should just group mid, honestly, for now. Just get that. They've still got two people dead, though, so... You know, we don't have to worry too much. I don't know where... Is Katarina AFK or some shit? I ain't seen her in like... Yeah, did she rage quit? I don't know where she is. That's nice. We'll go top as well. This is their whole base dead too, so beautiful stuff. A side note as well, by the way, guys, about getting this Baron here. Having this bottom inhibitor down is really, really useful. Because when you got bot inhib down, it means that bot lane is always going to be pushing in for you. So it's always going to be creating pressure for you, being annoying for the enemy team. And if the enemy team has their bot lane pushing in, it means that the top side of their map is pretty vulnerable. And what just so happens to be on the top side of the map? Baron. So it's a lot easier You know, if the enemy team is having to keep an eye on the minion waves in one side of the map, while you're pressuring an objective in the other side. Look at my mechanics, boys. Look at my mechanics. Shit. Amazing Shyvana mechanics. Oh, dear. That was funny shit. That was funny shit. I just want to take a look at the damage dealt that game. Because I don't know. Do you guys reckon I had a lot of damage dealt that game? I'm not sure. Game is still in progress. Wait, I might need to hide my... Wait, I'm going to hide this right here. Oh, you can see it still. Let me hide... Do I need to hide the client? Something funky happens. Yeah, okay, there we go. Sometimes this glitches out, so I need to hide it first. Okay, don't glitch out on me, baby. There we go. Damage wasn't too bad. Not too bad, considering the 1-4 start. We'll take it. But yeah, hopefully you guys can see the power of this build. It's certainly a pretty strong 1v1 build, I'll give you that much. And the split pushing's nice as well. I'm not sure whether or not I prefer it over like a Titanic Hydra build. I've gotten a bit more used to that, and I do quite like that build, so I don't know. But still, this is what the Koreans are running, so I just wanted to show it off a little bit. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, of course, cheeky thumbs up. You can subscribe to me for more League of Legends content, and you can find me on Facebook, on Twitter, and streaming on twitch.tv/foxtrot. Don't forget as well, guys, I do have a second channel, which is purely full gameplays every single day. So go subscribe to that one. It's Foxtrot Plays, the link to which is... Well, you can just Google it, Photoshop Plays. But it's in my little sidebar on YouTube as well. I should probably put it in my descriptions. Anyway, thanks for watching, boys. Have a good one. And I will see you in my next video.